those of you I don't know yet, my name is Augustus Brown, and my captain said I am a member of the graduating class, the best class ever. And I think you should be stressed that I did not volunteer for this. I understand, Chip, you may have volunteered. Great, Chip. You volunteered last year.
I was forced into it.
Yeah, my classmates either thought highly of me or they thought one more way to stick it to Augustus. So here I am. Enough about me. In all honesty, it was a shock to be elected as a speaker of our group, but as the anxiety subdued, I was really thrilled and excited about being the person chosen to give the final remarks of our class experience. So thank you, class. Before I get started, Karen, where are you? Karen, would you stand up real quick, please? I don't have anything to give you, but I think we're going to you've been the executive director of Leadership Change Strengths for 14 years.
There I
am. And
she started when she was 13.
That's exactly. Let me just say, you have shown us exactly what being a citizen in our community is supposed to be and look like. And on behalf of everybody here, especially our class, we love you. And we thank you for your leadership the past 14 years. Thank you very much. B-C-E-I-T-R-A-D. Best class ever. Is there really a doubt? 2015. I told you that wouldn't work for an entire speech. But thank you. So many of the remarks I received, guys, was just... they were so well stated and worth sharing. When asked what the program meant to her, Stacy said, "I feel so much closer to our community, leaders and all the residents. I've enjoyed learning so much about the beauty and the warts of our community and how Sandy Springs fits into the puzzle of our overall greater Atlanta experience." Thank you so much for that, Stacy. That was beautiful. John Paulson echoed some of that statement by saying how truly unique and great the Sandy Springs community is. And the pride shown in this community is unlike any community I know. Craig Kennedy, where are you, buddy? Craig Kennedy said this program allowed him to get a bigger picture of the creation. I said creation, so I mean, use that word. I use a lot of words I couldn't repeat here. I'd have a hard time. But the creation of the city and all that goes into it, including zoning laws and restrictions and cutting your lawn and incentives and strategic partnerships, etc. I asked Ben Carlson, I said, "Ben, what's your most memorable moment of the class?" And he reflected back on our activity back at the opening retreat, writing about me. And it's okay if I talk about what that is real quick. If you don't know what that exercise is, we have the personality outsource company come in, and part of our exercise was to write about leave. And so after badgering the instructor about getting further instructions, all we ever got was write about leave. Okay? So as you can imagine, all the personality types just kind of took off with their brains and their natural DNA writing about leave. And we had stuff ranging from the process of photosynthesis to leaf, the car, leaf flying in the wind, leaves being used as books, toilet paper in the woods, and so forth. Here's the picture. Well, Ben went on to say that our differing responses were so perfectly diametrical. It's what got him on board, he said. It made him realize that different viewpoints are not only prevalent, but valuable. Without the Augustus Browns of the world, we have no fiction. Ben, thank you. My buddy Mel, raise your hand. Here's Mel. So Mel, this is good. Mel actually said that what he'll surely never forget is Jeff. And how on every program day, with every presenter, Jeff had 2 questions and 14 comments. So Jeff, on behalf of Mel, and Tavia, and Pam, and Ed, and the mayor, and Bigfoot, and Gandhi, and the rest of our class, we want to thank you for your service and everything you've done for this community. I asked our classmates, what do you think our call to action should be? We're winding down, so what should our call to action be now that we're graduates of Leadership Sandy Springs? And Sean adamantly stated, for our class to at least become unofficial ambassadors of our communities and with our peers at work and in our communities. Brett expanded on that same question. Where are you, Brett? Move. Brett expanded on that, and he said, you gotta listen to this, he said, we've all heard arguments all year long about who is the best class of Leadership Sandy Springs.
Just throw it down.
And toward the latter part of the year, Brett said, I determined that we were indeed the best class ever. Who else can claim to be Carolyn's walk-off home run? Only the class of 2015. Carolyn decided to go out on top. But, Brett said, last week I realized the real answer, the true answer to the age-old question of which class, who is the best class of Leadership Sandy Springs? And the answer is next year's class. And it's our job to make sure that happens. Look around the room at all the people who have poured and invested into you. It's ROI time. We are challenged to make next year's class the best ever. Woo! Woo! As I wrap up, guys, I want to express some of my personal feelings about what the class meant to me this year. So allow me to take you mentally back to September, to our opening retreat, and back to Ben's flagship moment when he got on board the program of writing about leave. You see, I believe I was elected to be our class speaker because of what I wrote on that day. And I realized when I went back to look at what I wrote, I was writing about my hopes and my vision for what I wanted the class to be for me. This story I wrote was written back in September at our opening retreat, and I'm going to share it with you. For 10 minutes, again, write about me, go. I wrote, Leaf is my best friend. We met in the first grade and we were buddies at first sight. He was tall and skinny and I was short and fat. But for some odd reason, we became drawn to one another. That same year, we ended up on the same football team. Leaf was a quarterback and I was a running back. We had a great season. We went undefeated. Leaf and I really enjoyed playing football against our classmates at recess because he and I had the same sign language. Before he hiked the ball, he just looked at me, and I knew exactly what to do. That was about as close to cheating as Leaf and I ever got. We didn't mind cheating. No, sir. If we couldn't win fair and square, we'd rather lose than to ever cheat. We did a ton of winning in the first grade. In life, now that I'm 37 years old, I have failed as much as I've succeeded, but I wish my kids and every child the luck of having a friend like my buddy Lee. Jeff and I went out. He invited me to a network event on Tuesday night. He reminded me of something. He reminded me that most of us didn't know many people in our class when the program started. I was fairly new to Sandy Springs. If you remember, I was here for 4 months when we started the program, so I didn't know a soul. But I remember walking into that kickoff, that Fiesta kickoff that was so much fun, and there was a sea of name tags and new faces and awkward handshakes and forced conversations. And I believe I was looking for my leaf. Because of Leadership Sandy Springs, I had the privilege of being in a group project with some of you. I had dinner, that's right, Rebecca.
Best
team ever. Hold your applause. I had the privilege of doing dinner with some of you at your houses. Miss Mary Paulson, thank you for having us over. Kristen Moody, we appreciate that. But getting to connect with you in your homes on a one-on-one basis after work. And for some of you, I've actually carried tools with you in the rain for a better Sandy Springs. That was an experience, brother. And in some rare cases, about five or six of you here, I actually had the privilege of spending some one-on-one time with you, either at breakfast, at lunch, at dinner, or over cocktails. And that was absolutely true. But the story I wrote about Lee that day was about me hoping to connect with strangers, all the while committing to a better and making a better Sandy Springs. I think we did that. And as I look back on that story, on that Lee story, I realized that it was a cryptic mission statement to connect with you. I did that on so many levels, and I believe Sandy Springs will be a better community because of all of you this year have been my need. And for that, I'm forever grateful. Thank you.